Good morning. I thought today I would talk about one of the different ways that you can be a flower farmer. There are so many different ways you can make a living selling flowers. And there are lots of different kinds of flower farmer that you could be. You don't have to be a huge, enormous business. You can, so long as you know exactly how much turnover you would like, then you can work out what kind of a person you want to be. And one of a really nice way to make some money being a grower of flowers is by having a subscription system where people buy flowers from you on a regular basis. And the reason this is a really good way to do it is because it's regular income. You know what you're going to have, but you can also manage your time very carefully. You could have a subscription day, once a week, once a month, once a fortnight. You can decide what your season length is in advance. It's a really nice, tidy way of making a living. You may have to have other ways of, you know, you might have to be less organized. I mean, you know, cut your crop and hope that you sell it on the side of the road. But subscriptions are really nice because it's regular money and regular income. So today I have a few subscriptions. It's not my main core business, but I do have a few subscriptions. And so today I'm cutting my subscriptions and I'm getting them ready for collection. We have a system where most of our businesses click and collect now, but it used to be that we would send flowers throughout the country. And so these, the ones I'm doing today are the last bit of sending flowers around the country. And when these subscriptions are over, I will stop doing them because the price of having things delivered has gone through the roof. The price of cardboard, the price of packaging, everything has gone through the roof. So suddenly I would find that my poor old customers would have to pay a great deal more just for the delivery of the flowers. And I know that there are good flower farmers all around the country now. So I'm going to encourage my customers to go to flower farmers nearer them to order their flowers going forward. And I will encourage my business locally to expand so that I don't lose out on these orders, but they are available for people to collect from us. So come on, let's go cutting. I've washed my buckets. Let's get on. Another good thing about a subscription system is that you can plan in advance how many stems go into each bouquet, how much each bouquet is going to be sold for, therefore how many bouquets you need to sell. You need to know, you can know how long it takes you to cut them and how many stems to grow. It makes flower farming can be kind of an amorphous business where you're like, where do I start and where do I finish? But a subscription system is very tidy. I can say I need to sell 25 a week and I will cut them on Thursdays for delivery on Fridays or for collection on Fridays. It's going to take me this, I'm fast enough to do so many a day. It's brilliant, it's a really good system. Anyway, enough of this chat, I better cut them. Obviously, you won't be the only person working your fields while you're cutting. I have to say, I think the CSA system, the subscription system, works really, really well for people who are growing flowers as a side hustle because of the timings. If you are working 3 or 4 days a week elsewhere to earn your main living, then you can get on with that. But you know that Thursday, for example, is your subscription day. And you can grow a garden possibly less hefty than mine. You can grow a more manageable amount specifically for your subscriptions, which I think is really a tidy. I'm always looking for something to be tidy. I don't like amorphous and unmanageable. I like fixed and exact. I can't manage the weather. I can't fix how the season's going to go, but I can make sure that I
achieve my objective, which is at the end of the day, a bit of money in my pocket, while having a nice time in my garden. That's the point. And if you were working in your garden, if you wanted to make your garden work for you, maybe 1 or 2 days a week, then I think a subscription system through the summer would be really tidy and organised. You can manage it really well. There you go. That's what I think anyway. I was talking to my friend Ben Ranyard, who has a seed company called Higgledy Garden. He's very, very handy. And he said that he was talking to some other people about me. And apparently I'm quite fierce. I took this as a most enormous compliment, because he then said that he tells people who think that I'm fierce. I'm not fierce. I'm just telling people to get their shit together. I love that. So get your shit together. No, this is a good way to get your shit together if you want to run a really tidy little business, particularly if flower farming is a side hustle for you. That's what I think. Anyway, better get on. Oh, well, hello, the dahlias. I do love them. I love them. I love them. And I love them some more. The lovely thing about subscription bouquets, one of many, clearly, is that your customer sort of gets what you give them. You choose on a weekly, fortnightly, or monthly basis the best in your garden for your customers. They're not going to say to you, I want this flower and this flower and this flower. They're not. It's not a fuss pot. It's not a service for a fuss pot. It's a service for someone who loves to have a bouquet, a fresh garden bouquet, and they don't want to choose their flowers. They just want to get what you're given. So it's a lovely thing for you as the grower. You can grow anything you like. You can grow what pleases you for subscription bouquets. And yes, this is American Dawn. I know. Yeah. And this is Alyo. Yes, I know. And this is a peach pom-pom. Can you hear me? Without which I would not be, not single one of them. I love my dahlias with a kind of obsessive compulsive look. Oh, oh yes. Oh yes, I know, they're good, aren't they? Anyway, I'm banging on now. I better get cutting. I've got to school holidays, children, life. Always park your trolley in the shade, Mrs. Worthington. So, with a CSA or a subscription business, you can cut exactly what you need for your orders, which saves you so much time. If you're cutting opportunistically and you're hoping for sale, then it's a totally different headspace. Then you're cutting your whole crop, filling a shop or a stall, and hoping that people are going to buy it. This way, you could say, I've got one day, I need to do 20 bouquets to make this worth my while. So I'm going to sell 20 in advance. And once I've cut 20 and made 20, the orders will be collected from my front porch. I'm kind of done. It's a very, very simple way. You won't make your fortune running a CSA business, a subscription business, but particularly if you're running your flower farm as a side hustle, or you're starting out as a flower farmer and planning to expand the operation, but just having a tester for a year or two, this is a great way to do it. Right, better get on. What do my subscription bouquets look like? Well, sometimes, I've said this before, I'll say it again. Sometimes you just need the florist for scale. Yes, enormous. That's what my subscription bouquets look like. There you go. Well, obviously that's what they look like this week. They change through the year. They don't look like this every single week. But, oh, so it's my pleasure. I love doing my subscription bouquets because I can do whatever I feel like on the day. And oh yeah, just say yes to whatever I feel like. Okay, enough. Let's put this down. Right, it's time to pack them all up and have them ready for collection. I hope you've enjoyed this clip. I think subscription bouquets is a great way for people who are starting out at flower farming or who are running flower farming as a side hustle to their ordinary job. We do it because we love it, as well as doing wedding flowers and I don't know what else. So if you've enjoyed this clip, please subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon, and we'll tell you when we've got more clips coming up. And if any of the tips and tricks I've given you along the way are useful, then you can always buy me a coffee. The link to coffee buying is in the blurb to all my clips. And as an aside, I hold flower farming workshops online, here at the farm, flower farming intensives, and we have all sorts of small business workshops which help you think carefully and strategize so that you can turn your dream of farming your garden into a reality which actually helps pay the bills. Thanks very much for coming along, and I will see you soon. Bye.